In Britain, the British Prime Minister is fighting a referendum he thought couldn't be lost. In the USA, brash showman Ronald Craig is fighting a presidential election that nobody thought he could win. And over in Russia, President Igor Popov is using both events as part of his plan to destabilise the West. Three men who could change the course of the world forever. So nothing to do with reality, then?
Not based on reality.
Not based on any parallels in our current political
climate. I didn't call him Donald, I call him Ronald.
Any similarity is coincidental, is that what you're saying?
Completely incidental. No, I'll tell you something. The strange thing about it is everything I predicted turns out to be coming true. Yeah. I mean, it's perfectly obvious the Russians were pretty heavily involved in, you know, the American election. More and more comes out.
Oh, the evidence is tumbling out.
And it's perfectly obvious, to me at least, that there's far more in the Brexit vote, you know, than has so far come out.
But in terms of Russian involvement, you mean?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, getting the Facebook stuff, the data which went into Facebook, all the tweets, and above all, you know, some mega event like the massive migration crisis in the run-up to the...
Do you think
to the June 2016
another referendum as a consequence of that, though? Was it not a fair fight?
Well, I think if it was proved conclusively that everything I said happened Kompromat happened, then you might say, someone would say, well, you know, was this a fair fight? Let's not have a second referendum, but let's have a rerun of the first.
How does your son feel about that? Because obviously he was...
He is always relaxed. He's a very, very fine, relaxed man.
I know that by the time these come out, you've finished...
I'm going to send this one to your book club.
You've already given it to me.
You've given it
to my hands. I haven't had a chance to read it yet because we've been doing book club stuff, but I will look at it probably by this weekend. But things change. Has your view of the real American president changed as other people's views are beginning to change? I mean, people who would just completely dismiss him a year ago are beginning to sort of say, well, actually, maybe his foreign policy with Korea is sort of kind of working. Has your view of him changed since you finished this book?
I wouldn't have said my view of him has got better since I finished the book. He has confirmed really what I thought he was going to be. There are some attractive sides about it. In this particular book, of course, he gets shot in the backside with a hypodermic dart.
Wow.
By the Russian president.
You predict.
Well, he gets bugged in the run-up to, obviously, the American election because he got a tiger,
the
bum. Actually, he ends up with three hypodermic
darts. Three of them in the bum? Anyway. Oh, my God.
Well, look, the reason Joe's here is because he's going to use his entertainment and showbiz know-how to predict the next reality show that we think you might do.
So, Stanley, obviously, you are a master and I'm a celebrity, so we're kind of trying to...
No, I know, come on. I was a walk-on part.
We love you.
Don't forget, Jamie Lomas came second.
Stanley. So we thought maybe you'd be good at this summer's hit show, Love Island.
I sense an elephant trap coming.
There he is.
I think you
would be definitely 100% nerd type on paper.
What are these pants for, by the way?
Here we go. We know you like your inflatables from I'm a Celebrity. Try not to pop these ones. Here you go. We're thinking about a little bit of Strictly Come Dancing. So we've got you a feather boa.
So basically, this whole thing is a set.
Then what we thought was, you had all them creepy crawlies, you should have a go at MasterChef. So we got you that. I thought to myself after that, they ain't doing it no more, but what about the jump? Don't forget your skis. Got you some skis?
Well, I want to say that I've come on this show and I did a handstand on this very show.
You did, yes. But, Stanley, I can only apologise.
Have you guys picked your fancy or are you passing on a reality show?
Well, I think...
All right. Thanks for coming in, Stanley.